to our Bible this morning. It's the epistle of Paul to the Romans. Quando le sono sa con mai è la bolla di Paolo, l'apostolo Paolo che vi nessuno sono le loro mai Roma. Roma, Romans chapter 1 and we read from verse 13 to verse 17. Praise the Lord. Marotta di una colonna sina denta. Amen. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 1 from verses 13 to verse 17. Roma che non passa le vendua, ma la tiene tirca tolo, che tiene tirca vitu. I'm reading from the New King James Translation. Other translations, please follow along. It reads like this. Now I do not want you to be unaware, brethren, that I often planned to come to you, but was hindered until now, that I might have some fruit. Somebody say fruit.
Fruit.
Among you also, just as among the other Gentiles, I am a debtor both to Greeks and to barbarians, both to wise and to unwise. So as much as is in me, I am ready to preach the gospel to you who are in Rome also. Who is ready to preach the gospel this morning? I didn't get very many amen on that one. Okay, we'll work on that one. Verse 16. For I am not ashamed, somebody say, not ashamed, of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God. Somebody say, the power of God, to salvation for everyone who believes, for the Jew first, and also for the Greek. For in it is the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. Somebody say, the just shall live by faith.
The just shall live by
faith. Praise the Lord. The title to this message this morning is The Power of the Gospel of Jesus Christ. Title of this message, The Power of the Gospel of Jesus Christ. Na kaukaua ni kosipeli ke Jesus Christo. What is power in Hindi? Shakti. Alright. Okay. So the gospel of Jesus Christ has power in it. Amen?
Amen.
The gospel of Jesus Christ has the power to transform and change the life of any person, no matter what kind of background they come from. Na gospel ke Jesus Christo itiko kina na kaukaua me beso ta ke induna tamata. Italia se matangali bubale se background bagatabe lagu mai kina. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm going to do preaching today, not so much teaching. Is that all right?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The power of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the ability of the gospel of Jesus Christ can change a person, no matter what kind of background, what kind of situation they may be facing right now. Can you say amen?
Amen.
You see, the power of God is in His Word. Where is the power of God?
His Word.
It's in His Word. Amen?
Amen?
When we obey and do what the Word of God says, the power of God is released. Hello? Nito talay rao rao kino was ni kalo kay kasoba sa kamara na siya na kuko wa ni kalo na mara kina kuko ni kalo itigong ara na nabosa. Hallelujah.
Amen.
John chapter 1 verses 1 and 2. Let me prove it to you. In the beginning was the
Word.
And the Word was with
God.
And the Word was
God.
He was in the beginning with God. Who was in the beginning with God?
The Word.
Amen?
Amen.
The Word was in the beginning with God. The Word was God. Therefore, the Word did the creation in the beginning. Amen. Are you beginning to see something today? So the Word was available in the beginning to create the things. Praise God. This is what it is. Wherever the Word is, who's there? Wherever God is, who's there? Ah, you're getting it. Praise God. Amen. See, when God created all things, He just spoke the Word and things came into existence. Can you say that? Did you see that?
Yes.
When God created things, He just spoke the Word.
Amen.
Amen. Come, you still not convinced yet. Come to Psalms 33. I'm trying to prove to you this point. When you get this, on a sin imposta pra Italia, you will be careful of the words that you say. Praise the Lord. I'm getting somewhere with this. If you catch this, this will transform your life. Psalms 33, verses 6 and verse 9. Okay? Are you there? Say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Psalms 33, verses 6 and verse 9 says, by the word of the Lord. By the what?
The word.
By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. Can I read that again? By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made, and all the host of them by the breath of his mouth. For he spoke, he what? He spoke, and it was done. He commanded, and it stood fast. Have you ever wondered why the sun hasn't moved 1 degree this way, 1 degree that way? Have you ever wondered why the moon hasn't shifted from its axis? Why the earth hasn't gone closer to the sun 1 degree or come off the sun 1 degree? Have you wondered why it stays within its rotational axis? Have you ever wondered? It's the word of God. The word of God has sustained all these planets and all this solar system as they are because God said it and it has remained until today.
Amen.
You notice when God spoke it, he hasn't taken back that word. And therefore, they are still creating now. We have solar system that's still creating. Why? Because God spoke it and it's still going forth. Praise the Lord. But through someone that wants to go. Hallelujah. You're going to see Pentecostal pastor today. Praise the Lord. I'm full of fire. Hebrews 11:3 it reads like this. This is a common scripture. We read all the time, but we miss it. We miss the understanding of it. It says, by faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. Amen? So the things that which are seen were not made from the things which are visible. This is what it means. It means God didn't create the visible realm for what he can see. He created the visible realm from the unseen realm. Because faith is what? What's the definition of faith? Faith is the things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. See, there used to be a doctrine in the Assemblies of God. I'm not sure whether you're familiar with it. There used to be a doctrine in the Assemblies of God that God created from nothing. And it's not true. Have you ever heard that? That God created from nothing. How many you've heard that? There used to be a doctrine in the Assemblies of God. I'm not sure with the other Pentecostal denomination. But there used to be a doctrine, a teaching that went throughout the Assemblies of God. And pastors to preach it all the time. They said that God created from nothing. Have you ever heard of that? Nakalo pa yung muli may nasena. Because God didn't create from nothing. Two requirements that God needed to create. Tell me. Come on. What did God needed to create what now has been created? The invisible realm and the visible realm, God created all of them. There was two requirements, two things that he needed, two ingredients. Can anybody say it? Can anybody name it? We just read the scriptures. The word and what else? Come on. What else? Faith. Eh? God created the invisible realm and the visible realm by faith and by the spoken word. So, Torah. Eh? Nakalang po ibibuli mo pa yaman ano ang bosa kina ba? Bagabalta. Okay. So when you hear somebody say God created these things from what? From nothing. Don't believe it. I say, you're not reading. Show them the scriptures I just showed you. Okay? So, God just spoke and things came into being. The word of God is a creative force. Amen? Now, what's the goal of it? Two kids on a cocoa, my voice not going to be bully. So, you see, in healing, when you speak the word of God
to a person who needs healing, the word of God can do the creative miracle in that person when you pray for that person through the word of God by faith. Amen? Amen. This happens. Things happen when God speaks. You see, the Holy Spirit cannot do anything unless the word of God has been spoken. Did you get that? The Holy Spirit cannot do anything unless the word of God is spoken. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Somebody has the word of God before the Holy Spirit can act on it. And the water that you are out of time, Mendua is the Buddha, the Masulaka, now Bosanikara, when you barely get out of time. Amen. You want me to prove it to you? Come to Genesis chapter 1. You're probably thinking, where did he get all these things from? Well, I can tell you where I got it from. I got it from the Bible. Amen. I got it from the Bible. It's all in the Bible, baby. It's all in the Bible. Hallelujah. Amen. Go to Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. All right. Are you enjoying this morning's service? Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. And it reads, the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Now listen to this. Now before the Holy Spirit hovered over the face of the waters, did anything change? Was anything created before the Holy Spirit hovered? Nothing. Well, let me ask you this. When the Holy Spirit was hovering over the waters, was anything created?
No.
Okay, let me ask you this question then. After the Holy Spirit hovered over the waters, was anything created? What?
Light.
Huh? Well, can you prove to me from the Bible? Where does it say that after the Holy Spirit hovered, the light was created? Can I get that one? She's from the Bible. Tell me where. Show me from the Bible.
Verse 3.
What happened in verse 3? Hang on. You're going too fast. You're preaching my messages. I might as well give her the microphone. Yeah, preach. Okay? So you notice in verse 3, what happened? Read it to me. What happened? Then God said. Hello? Then God said. What was the Holy Spirit waiting for? Somebody had to speak the word. You see? Nothing was created. No moon, no stars, no tree grew, or anything was created unless God what? Spoke. Those are the two. So the Holy Spirit is limited to what the Holy Spirit can do unless you and I, we take our rightful position of who we are in Christ and speak the word with the authority that God has given you as child of the Most High God.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
That's so wonderful. Amen.
Amen.
Nothing was created when the Holy Spirit was hovering over the earth. What was the Holy Spirit waiting for?
The
spoken word. The Holy Spirit was waiting for someone to speak the word of God so that the Holy Spirit can act on it. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. The word of God has the power to create things and turn your situation and circumstances around when the word of God is spoken to it by faith. You gotta speak to your marriage.
Amen.
You gotta speak to your situation. You gotta speak to your finances. You gotta speak to it with the authority of God's word by faith.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, my brothers and my sisters, if you are born again, you have the same power as God has.
Yes.
I said, if you are born again, you have the same power that God has. Do Patingan na usap ang restriction. Come on, you guys, work with me here. Come on. Go to John. Come to Job chapter 22. Job 22, verse 28. Chop it. Job. Say, I see the job. Job. Sorry, it's my Australian accent. I apologize. Job. Chop it. Can I call it chop it? Is that right? Chop it. Can we go back to psychology? Talk to it tonight. Job 22 verse 28. Praise the Lord. Forgive me, please. I can't help this. I'm in Aussie. Praise the Lord. Job 22 verse 28 says, you will also declare a thing and it will be established for you. Is that what it says in your Bible?
Yes.
What does it say in your Bible? You will also declare a thing and what will happen? It will be established for you. So I like that. That's why you gotta declare it. Eh? That's why you gotta declare it. Job 22 verse 28. Eh? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You're learning something today. Let's go to a New Testament equivalent to this thing so we can just kind of match it up. Matthew chapter 8. Let's go to Matthew chapter 8, please. Are you okay? Are you comfortable?
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna get it uncomfortable in a minute. Praise the Lord. Amen. Marata to the Lord. What's so someone that we just saw in the first time? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Okay, is that time for me to stop? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. No man is out of my salvation. Hallelujah. Okay. Matthew chapter 8, verses 23 to 27. 23 to 27. Praise the Lord. And it reads like this. Now when he got into a boat, his disciples followed him, and suddenly a great tempest arose, and the boat was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. You can rest on Jesus. But you can rest on Jesus. Amen. You don't need to worry. You don't need to worry. You don't need to be anxious. You don't need to get stressed out just because your boat is going through a storm. Hallelujah. Because there's no other captain that is better in this world than the Lord Jesus Christ. He can captain your boat to safety, to calm waters. You just gotta trust him. Hallelujah. Your marriage or your relationship may be going through a tough time right now. But you can depend and put your trust in Jesus. He'll bring you out of that situation. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Verse 25 says, then his disciples came to him and awoke him saying, Lord, save us. We are perishing. So the disciple just wanted to wake him up and tell him, Lord, we are perishing. Uturang kita sa lenga. Uturang ito sa lubo. Uturang sa kabaso ng mula. Uturang sa lalamay ng bawasi. Uturang sa rebon ng bulago ni shopping. Jesus, help. How many of you have gone to a prayer closet like that? Siya na sarang hindi doon na namin. Come on! Kena kene! Hindi na tatala! You know what you girls do? You go there and you think you can... I don't want to use the... You can convince God by crying. How many you girls have done it? Right? See, when the girls cry, you see, they do that. You know? They do that. See, with the boys, we're different. See, when our nose starts to run, this is what the boys do. They just go. To run, we just go like this, and we just go like that, and we start all over again. And all the girls say, yuck, three times. Yuck, yuck, yuck. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Come on. Sino talaga tuntunan mo sa kapatid ng breakfast? Eh, so pick up mo naman mo sa kapatid siya. Praise the Lord. You don't love me, because you know you do it too, right? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What's so much? 26 says, but he said to them, why are you so fearful, all you of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. Verse 27 says, so the men marveled, saying, who can this be that even the winds and the sea obey him? Notice the disciples were surprised that even the weather obeyed Jesus. Huh? You see, you have authority over the weather. Let me say it again. You have authority over the weather. You can speak the word of God to the weather and command the weather to obey, to bend its knees, okay, to the word of God that you're speaking against it. If you want sunny weather, you can command the clouds to go away. Let the sun shine through and dry up your clothes, your washing. Hallelujah! It's here! I just said it to you, it's in the Bible. How come? You have the same authority. It's been given to you. You have authority over the weather. You have authority over a hurricane. No hurricane has to hit this place. Why? Because you're here and you're speaking the word of God to it by faith. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, I'm fired up today. Don't slow me down. Praise the Lord. You see, Jesus expected us to speak the word of God to our troubles and whatever problems we may be facing, and they have to obey us, just like the winds and the waves. Somebody say amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Can I take you to another scripture? Come to Mark 11. Mark 11, 23 and 24. Praise the Lord. If you've been listening to Pastor Kenneth Hagin, this is his favorite scripture. Praise the Lord. Mark 11, verses 23 and 24. Marika, is that right?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Marika, what's it going to do? Tiene rosa no boca todo, que tiene rosa no boca va. For assuredly, somebody say assuredly.
Assuredly.
I say to you, whoever speaks, whoever declares, amen, to this mountain. What's your mountain right now? What's your mountain right now? Sickness? Debt? An unsaved loved one? Marriage is just about broken? A broken life? A pain? A hurt? Broken relationship? What's your mountain right now? Identify that mountain. Identify that mountain right now. You need a job? What's your mountain right now? Now, what do you want to do about the people who are starving at Tumango? How do you want to start at Tumango? Praise the Lord. Let's go back to our text. It says, I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, whoever speaks to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. Verse 34 says, therefore I say to you, whatever things you ask, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will what?
Have them.
But you notice, you gotta speak it. This is where most Christians, they get meditational prayer. You understand when I say meditational prayer? And then everyone told me, sometimes it's been taught in the church. Sometimes it's been taught in the church that you don't have to speak. You just be quiet. And you know, it's your quiet time. Don't make a noise. You know something? When you do that, all kinds of thoughts come into your mind. Have you noticed? You notice it's different when you begin to pray aloud. When you can hear yourself praying, why? Because when you speak, your atmosphere changes. Don't know. Because the devil is the prince of power of the air. Gotta speak. If you want your environment, your atmosphere around you to change, you've got to speak the word of God aloud. Let me join this with faith.
Romans, I think it's 4, Romans 4, 17. Or the Romans 10, I think it's Romans 10, 17, it says, faith comes by what? Faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. The English translation of it is much clearer. That word it says, that faith comes by hearing, not having heard. Let me say it again. Faith comes by hearing, not having heard. This is what happens. You need to hear the word of faith again and again and again and again and again for faith to rise up. Faith to rise up. You won't get it just hearing it one time. You've got to continue to hearing it, and hearing it before faith rises up to the level where you can believe God for anything. You understand what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. That's why you've got to declare the word of God out aloud to your situation. Speak to it. If you want that mountain to be removed and cast into the sea, you've got to speak to it, not meditate. Did you get that?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You've got to speak to that mountain. Speak to your mountain. Speak to your mountain. Praise the Lord. You've got to speak to the mountain because you can have what you are. Say, Ephesians 24, it says, you can have what you want. You can have what you say. Is that right?
Yes.
Huh? Yeah, I think it's in verse 23, where it says, the last part of verse 23 says, he will have whatever he wants.
Say.
Nobody doesn't say you can have whatever you meditate. Hello? In verse 23, it says, you can have whatever you
say.
See, if your Bible is color-coded, it's in red. Is it in red? Yeah, that's Jesus speaking. Can Jesus lie? Hello? If your Bible is color-coded, it's in red. So that's Jesus speaking. So in other words, he knows what it takes for your prayers to be answered. Amen? That's why he's teaching it. He's teaching it so we can understand something from it and then apply the principle that he's teaching. Amen? Is that too deep? Or did you understand that? See, Hebrews 11:6 said, but without faith, it is a what? Impossible to please him. How do we please God?
By faith.
For he who comes to God must believe that he is. Or in some other translation, it's in the NIV, says that he exists. Amen? And that God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. I think in the Ephesian translation, the apostle word diligently is missing in it. Diligently is not in there. Our Ephesian Bible needs to be retranslated, man. I tell you what. The Ephesian Bible has robbed us of many of the promises of God. Praise the Lord. See, speech or words wasn't created by God for communication. I lost you guys right there. You just looked at me and go, what? Let me say it again. Speech or words wasn't created by God for communication. Nabosa, you want to know the reason or the purpose God created speech or words? You want to know why? No, you don't want to know why. You want to know why?
Yes.
Want to know why? Are you sure you want to know why?
Yes.
Come again. Come again to Genesis. Come again to Genesis.
No.
Were you serious?
Yes.
Honest?
Yes.
All right. I'll show you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We won't read it, okay? It's in there. You can read it for yourself. Okay. So when God said, when God spoke. When God said, let there be light, let there be the sun, let there be this, let there be that, let there be that. So when God said, who was there with God? And who else? And who else? If you notice, there was no person there. Because mankind was created on the last day. Is that right? So who was God talking to? Who was God communicating with when he was speaking, let this, let that, let this, let that? Who was he communicating with? he talking to? Who was he conversing with? Well, there are wrong people saying to you, what the kind of color I'm going to get up where? Me re re me go me ya go me ya me ya me ya me ya. What the wrong people saying about the two? You notice there was nobody there. Nobody was there talking and conversing. God didn't ask for somebody's opinion. Can we make the sun today? Tomorrow will be a good day. Tomorrow, Tuesday, we'll make it on Tuesday. You notice, God wasn't asking for anybody's opinion. He didn't need anybody's opinion to create what he created. Did you notice that? Praise the Lord. So God was talking to nobody, yet he was talking. Why? Why was he talking when there was nobody to talk to? You want to know why? Speech or words were created for creation. Notice he had to speak before anything was created. So speech or words were created by God for creation. Amen.
Amen.
Our words have the power to create things when spoken in faith. Our words have the power to change situations and circumstances when spoken in faith. Amen. See, when you speak your situation through the word of God by faith, that marriage has to change. That person, it's your husband's tough luck that he married you because he's gonna get saved. Doesn't matter how drunk he is. You women are remarkable people. I tell you what. You've got such a tenacity on the inside that, you know, a husband can be drunk for 10 years, but you notice if a wife is saved, she'll pray for 10 years, and sooner or later, that husband will come into the Lord because of the prayers by the wife. Amen. God placed an ability in you women that you never say never until something breaks in the atmosphere. Praise the Lord. You have a Holy Ghost tenacity in you. Don't ever lose that. You will never lose that. There's a Holy Ghost determination in you that you're not prepared to give up until you get your breakthrough. Amen?
Amen.
Never lose that. Can I encourage the women today? Never lose that. You stick with it, and watch what God do. Amen. You pray until what? Until something happens.
Amen.
You pray until. You pray until something happens. You pray until something breaks. You pray until a miracle is established. Never give up.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Many marriages have been saved because the wife never gives up.
Amen.
Many families have stayed together because the wife never gives up.
Amen.
You know, which is okay, yeah, whatever, go to church. Yeah. But the women, you know, the women will stick with it, and they will stick with it. That's what I said. There's a Holy Ghost determination in you women. Never lose that. That's an ability given to you by God.
Amen.
Especially when you're born again, God anoints that ability. Never lose that. What is so than I've been teaching? Let me remind you of the scripture I told you before. Job 22 verse 28. You will also declare a thing and it will be established for you. In conclusion, whatever you may be going through right now, speak the word of God to it by faith. Command that situation in the name of Jesus to bow its knees to the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let me just pray for you. Can everybody just stand up for me? Let me just pray for you. Hallelujah.